Okay children, welcome back. Coming to surface charge distribution. In the previous video, we have seen the linear charge distribution. Now we go for surface charge distribution. Very simple case I will discuss here. There is a sheet given to you. Sheet means it's a two-dimensional thing. The sheet has an area of A on which a charge, positive charge, is given plus capital Q. You can take negative also, there is no issue. So total charge Q is distributed uniformly over the surface area of area A. So this is known as sigma, this is known as surface charge density or aerial charge density, whatever you call surface charge density. Sigma means surface charge density. Units are coulomb per meter square, right? Now the question is, I want to find force between this and a charge Q here, small Q here. How do we find? Very simple to understand. I consider a small element in this. First, consider a small element. This small element is having an area dA. dA. Okay. Charge dQ. Okay. So, dQ is nothing but charge on the area. What is charge per unit area? Sigma. Sigma is the charge per unit area, and on this area dA, the charge would be sigma dA. This is for unit area. See, this is sigma is per unit area, and for area dA, this is the charge. Okay. So, what is the distance between these two? Let us say R. Now I write Coulomb's law dF is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught dQ into Q by R square, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q sigma dA by R square. Very simple. Now, I want to find the force acting, net force experienced by this due to this, or net force between these two. To find net force, what we have to do? Again, the same thing, integration, right? So in order to find F, we have to integrate F. In this integration, whatever the constants are there, they have to be brought out. These are all constants here. Of course, R is also not constant, R is a variable. Because R changes, if you consider dQ here, R will vary. If you consider this, R will vary. Even direction also changes, right? That I will explain to you. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q sigma, I write Q sigma here. Here I put integration dA by R square. Here you don't come across vector notation, so that we can go for Q sigma by 4 pi epsilon naught dA by R cube into R cap. The limits of integration will vary from case to case. This is of our surface charge distribution. In this, we define a parameter called sigma. Sigma is known as surface charge density. So like this we will do. In the next case, volume charge distribution. Volume charge distribution means the charge is distributed throughout the volume. Okay. So, suppose you take a three-dimensional thing which has certain volume V, charge is Q. So, rho equal to Q by V, charge per unit volume, units are coulomb per meter cube. This is a rare case. We have got only one case of this. which also we come across in competitive, not in theory. Rho can be defined as dq by dv. So what is rho here? Charge per unit volume. Per unit volume the charge is rho. If I consider a small element of volume dv, then the charge will be rho dv. So on this, well, in this volume I consider a small element cuboid like this, which has got a volume dv. The charge on this will be rho dv, which is equal to dq. I keep a charge here somewhere, small q. I want to find the force between these two. Separation is r. Just like in the previous case, we can go for df is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q dq by r square. If you want to find the total force, we have to go for integration of df 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q. I can take dq as rho dv. I take it as rho, right? Integral dv by r square. That's all. I can get the force. Okay. So I have explained to you the three cases. One is lambda. What is lambda? Lambda is linear charge density. Linear charge density, very simple to understand. Linear charge density means charge per unit length. Sigma, surface charge density, that means charge per unit area. Rho, volume charge density, charge per unit volume. So we have three such types of charge densities which come under continuous charge distribution. Right? Bye.